This ebook is designed specially for railway and SSC steno exams. A lot of contractions and advanced physiographics are used for speedy writing. For the convenience of students, this ebook is designed on A4 sheets and it is printable. We highly recommend to practice it thoroughly. You can collect the ebook from the link given in the description box below.
The pandemic's second wave may have subsided, but hopes for a smooth rebound in the economy in tandem with easing restrictions remain muddled. With the inflation numbers for May compounding the problem, the soaring pace of rising prices, both retail and wholesale. In the month that saw widespread lockdown, like restrictions has come as a negative surprise. Inflation based on the wholesale price index is reckoned to have hit a 25-year record of nearly 13%, while retail inflation touched a 6-month high of 6.3%, while runaway fuel prices that include high excise duties and taxes were a key factor in driving up both the inflation indices. They were not the only ones at work. Retail inflation in food hit a 6-month high of 5% from barely 2% in April, with pulses and eggs as well as edible oils leading the surge. Fuel and light inflation hit 11.6%, the highest in over 9 years, and no respite is in sight on this front, as pump prices for petrol raced past ₹100 a liter in even more parts of the country this month. Diesel has also crossed the century mark in Rajasthan's Sri Ganganagar, where freight costs add up on top of state and central taxes. Even if one were to discount food and fuel prices, core inflation has crossed the 6% mark for the first time in 31 months and is estimated at 6.6%. Reacting to the April retail inflation print of 4.3% after averaging a steep 6.2% through 2020-2021. The RBI governor had remarked earlier this month that it brought some relief and elbow room for sticking with growth supportive policy. If anything, May's inflation prints leave no such room for maneuver, though the bank's monetary policy committee may not switch away from its dovish policy. No further easing of interest rates can be expected at these price levels. Most economists expect inflation to remain higher than the average 5.1% estimated by the central bank for this year. If the government wants the RBI to persist with its accommodative approach to facilitate growth, it must take some actions of its own to curb price rise, including meaningful cuts in fuel taxes that the RBI governor has been advocating since February. So far, it has only obfuscated the issue with arguments ranging from the states should cut taxes first to let's bring petroleum products under GST, and the latest claim by the petroleum minister who admitted that the prices are problematic. But the government is saving money to spend on welfare schemes and buying vaccines for a population already reeling from job and income losses and higher medical costs since the pandemic's onset. The persistently high inflation is untenable. No welfare scheme can offset its disproportionately adverse impact on the poor.
You have liked the video? Hit the like button and consider subscribing.